Hello there, and welcome to A to Z Domain to Genesis 11 Enlightenments. On this episode, scorpions. All scorpions are arachnids, a class of invertebrates that famously have 8 legs. Scorpions also have 2 pincers and a spiked tail. The class also includes spiders, ticks, and mites, making Arachnida one of the most feared and hated of all eukaryote classes.
This fear may be well-founded, though the number of lethal scorpion stings are unknown. The word scorpion comes directly from the ancient Greek scorpios, a word in itself that comes from a Proto-Indo-European word meaning to cut. The northernmost natural colony of scorpions is 50 degrees north, named Pararoctinus boreus. The northern scorpion is the only scorpion species to live in Canada, again natively. The species name boreus is Latin for northern. The genus's name is harder to tell though. Parur means small in Latin and octo means 8, and the phrase parur octonus, when put into Google Translate, gives out 8 little hands. Quite fitting for an arachnid, though the genus name Androctonus translates to man-killer, so the genus name may also mean small-killer. The description parur, even if not the genus's stem, is accurate, as a northern scorpion's length is reportedly 35 millimeters long, the same length as its alien counterpart, the true most northerly scorpion. The true furthest northern scorpion colony is at 51 degrees north, on the Isle of Sheppey, off the coast of the United Kingdom. The species is the European yellow-tailed scorpion, Euscorpius flavicordis, or translated from Latin, European scorpion, yellow-tailed. There's another yellow-tailed population in the Austrian town of Krems an der Donau. E. flavicordis is an ambush predator, mainly preying on woodlice and other insects. Its sting is not very potent and to humans is similar to that of a bee. The need for a potent sting isn't truly required, as the scorpion's burrowing and shy nature helps them to evade most dangerous situations, and their prey being small insects also helps, as the 30 to 45 millimeter length of the predator remains larger than most of its prey. The European yellow-tailed scorpion is thought to have arrived in Sheppey from Italy on a cargo ship carrying masonry or fruit. The masonry makes more sense as the scorpion lives in built-up areas and are known to burrow in the walls of old buildings as well as underground, but always below 500 meters of altitude. Not all scorpions dig to survive though. The scorpion Androctonus australis is the largest of this episode's 3 scorpions at lengths of up to 10 centimeters and can withstand sandstorms, not by burrowing, but thanks to the many dome shapes on its exoskeleton. The model of its exoskeleton has been recommended for use on planes and helicopters, making this a scorpion who's of great value to many areas of science. A. australis is also the most controversial scorpion in my opinion. Known as the southern man-killer, the venom in its sting is not only being used as a current spray-on pesticide, but also in genetically modified cabbages to kill off insects who try to feed on them. This cabbage scorpion's venom is comprised of 4 parts of the toxin Androctonus australis, Hector insect toxin, parts 1, 2, 4, and 5 to be precise. Of the 4, 3 parts only target insects, but AAHIT4 may also affect crustaceans, arachnids, and mammals. Why AAHIT3 is not part of the toxin, I cannot say, and could not find any articles stating its existence.
And with that, this has been 11 Enlightenments. See you next time.